Denver, Colorado. Navarro getting ready to make his walk. He was an alternate on the 96 Olympic team. Had a very colorful amateur record of 120 victories, just 17 losses. He was supposed to fight an NABF title fight against Castillo tonight. But something happened there, so he gets to fight Kendrick Relliford. This guy's been around. He's fought Joe Messi. He had a loss to Willie Chapman. He's going to try to stay busy, he says, because he feels like this heavyweight division is wide open.
And he's a rarity. He's a guy that could have turned pro after 1996, but waited till the year 2000. Sort of like an athlete in another sport who goes to college first and then turns pro. And he decided to go to Michigan University and get his political science degree. So he went to college, and now here's his opponent.
This is Kendrick Relliford, 8-3-1 from Fort Worth. He was 5-0. And then all of a sudden he went 0-2-1, and you asked him about that day.
Yeah, he said that he had bad decisions, which fighters will often say, and that's what's in their belief, fighting on the road. So he has to try to do something to get over the top and take it out of the judge's hands by being more busy and asserting himself more, because otherwise these heartbreak losses can set you down the wrong road.
Relevant told me he's been working on his head movement, working on his defense. He thinks there's most... position that he's improved on is that he's improved on his conditioning. So we'll find out about that as we get this one underway. Let's go to our ring announcer, Damian Pinto, to get this one underway. Damian.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome as we kick off our brand new 2004 boxing season. And we're here in the next installment of the Backyard Brawl Series. All right, sports fans, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Warriors Boxing Promotions Incorporated, in association with the Seminole Coconut Creek Casino, proudly present a Night of Heavyweights live professional boxing brought to you by the Seminole Coconut Creek Casino here in beautiful Coconut Creek, Florida. Just a reminder, people in attendance, there is no flash photography permitted at any time during these boxing bouts. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's fights are under the sanctioning body of the Florida State Boxing Commission. Your chairman, Alvin Enzi, vice chairman, Eduardo Macasa, commissioners Donald Bowen, Jerry Wages, and Dr. Donald Perry. Your executive director, Chris Meffert. All tonight's bouts are scored on a 10-point must system, and the 3-knockdown rule is only in effect for non-title fights. Your ring officials, as designed by the Florida State Boxing Commission, attending ringside physicians Dr. Alan Fields and Dr. Stanley Simpson. Your judges this evening at ringside, Rich Green, Michael Pernick, Peter Trematera, Rocky Young, and Gary Ritter. And the man in charge of the time at the bell, your timekeeper, Carmine Sciracella. All right, fight fans, here we go. 10 rounds, and this is your heavyweight division. First, before we introduce our combatants, your referee, the man in charge of the action when the bell rings, referee Bill Connors. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, hailing from our nation's capital of Washington, D.C., now fighting out of Denver, Colorado. He weighed in at 225 pounds. He has a professional record of 18 victories with only 2 defeats, 16 victories coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, he fights from the blue corner in the black trunks trimmed in red, introducing Navarro. A touch of sleep, Williamson! His opponent stands opposite in the corner to my left, hailing from Fort Worth, Texas, and weighing at 238 fighting pounds. He has a professional record of 8 victories, 3 defeats, 1 draw, with 5 big victories coming my way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from your red corner, wearing the black trunks, trimmed in white, I get to you, Kendrick, the Apostle Relliford. Once again, here is your referee, Bill Connors. Last minute instructions, 10 rounds in your heavyweight division.
All right, so referee Bill Connors calls the combatants to the center of the ring. Relaford, just 21 years of age, at 238 pounds. He's a big one. And now the fight is a.
Let's go, bring him out here. All right, both got your instructions in the dressing room. I want you to listen to my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. These are right on the border. They're fine. Any questions over here? Any questions over here? Touch them up. Let's go.
Remember, this is sanctioned by the Florida State Athletic Commission. Scoring is a 10-point must system. No standing eight count. There is a three knockdown rule in the state of Florida. Dave, in that tail.
And Williamson, 14 years older, 2 inches taller, and 2 inches to his advantage on the reach. So the numbers say Williamson has the experience. Relaford wants youth to be served.
Yeah, and he's 13 pounds heavier as Relaford. Let's see if he can take advantage of it. Got a slick-looking body on him. We go round number one. Bob Sheridan here with Dave Bontempo and Mark Goldberg handling the interviews for us. The man with the red trim on his trunks is Williamson with the black shoes. Relaford is the man with the white trim and the white shoes.
This fight's an interesting adjustment for Williamson. He was stopped in the first round by Macy in his last bout. He made $175,000 for that fight. Now he said he's dropping down like into the $5,000 range, and that's psychologically difficult for a lot of guys, but he has the right attitude for it. He said, I have to build myself back up again to get into those big paydays. Many guys cannot make that road back. Williamson says he can.
Well, on the other hand, we want to see just how good Relaford is. He's 8-3, 5 KOs in his 8 victories. Williamson has 16 stoppages in his 18 victories. Williamson is 35 years of age and Relaford at 21, so Relaford just coming up. And Williamson, needless to say, has got to get it done in a hurry. And after being stopped by Messi, he wants to get it done in this fight for sure. Both guys working with the jabs here in the early going of round number one. Looping left hand by Relaford that time. Not really looping either. He's powerful.
And he considers the right hand his best shot, so we'll see if he's able to drop that in on touch of sleep. And he did get that in grazing fashion moments ago.
Well, he said he wanted to be more aggressive and use some head movement. We haven't seen too much head movement, but he's been aggressive enough here in the first round. Almost slapping with that right hand. Yeah. I don't like that slapping movement with the right hand. You're not going to get a lot of power with that because he didn't turn the punch over and get his hip in.
Had he done that, Carl, that would have been a nice shot for him because it landed flush, just not with a lot of emphasis.
Stiff jab in the face that time of Relaford. The jab again by Williamson. Williamson throws the jab, loads up the right hand, catches lightly above the left ear of Relaford. Relaford staying outside the shots right now. Williamson, now he comes in, throws the right hand. That right hand, I'm glad to see that he turned it over because I was concerned, not having seen Relaford fight before, that if he throws his right hand the way I saw that last one with the lack of technique, maybe just his balance was off, but he certainly threw the right hand with a little bit more authority that time.
Made up for that other one with those last two.
He sure did. Williamson hangs on a bit. Still has a tendency to slap a little bit, even though that was more definitive. But you know something, those punches that landed are going to give him this round. He loaded up that windmill shot that time. Williamson tries to come with an uppercut, digs to the body, and now right at the bell, Bill Carter says, hey, keep the punches up. I don't know, Relaford landed what appeared to be more power shots as far as I'm concerned that round.
Big shots, though. And Williamson. Nice. Chin will be tested perhaps again. Relaford closing in. Scores the right hand. Did not catch him flush with that one. And then over the top, a grazing shot, but closing in, and we'll see if he's able to get that exactly on the mark as the rounds go along. The second look, not as big as they looked the first time, but the judges don't see the
reason. Don't stop jabbing.
In that corner with Relaford is his dad, Kenneth Relaford. This is his friend, Stacy McKinley, my good friend Manny Fernandez, how many he is. Here we go, round number two. Relaford with the white shoes and the white trim. Williamson with the black shoes and the red trim on his trunks. Relevant starting out with that jab. Taking lightly the chest area, but he just trying to touch up Williamson, get himself in position to land the right hand again. And there's the head movement that he talked about, so
yeah,
the training in the gym is paying off for him. He comes in with the head down, though. I don't like that yet. You got to be throwing coming in, not being with your forehead.
And Relaford trying to do the bobbing and weaving, getting in and trying to test the chin of Williamson. Now, Williamson had his jaw broken against Robert Wiggins and came back from that injury, which occurred early in the fight, and overcame a broken jaw to win the fight. Real testament to his courage, but you can see how he carries the left hand down. He leaves the jaw open, and Relaford's been able to get to that a few times in this fight.
Well, Ken Relaford is in the corner. It's a dad and trainer of Kendrick Relaford, and there he is. And Kenneth, what do you see your man doing? What are the good things you're doing?
Well, he's looking good right now. He's taking his time, keeping his eye on it. But I just want him to jab a little bit more. Keep that jab working!
Wanted to keep the jab working, of course. He's landed the right hand pretty good, and he is showing a little bit more head movement.
Come on, get that jab working, throw it straight.
I know you've been working with him on that.
Yeah.
Ken, what about going against an older fighter? Did you have a sense of trying to apply more pressure and make him use his legs so you can wear him down?
Well, at the same time, repeat that question.
Do you feel you can wear down the older fighter, even though Williamson has experience? He's 35 and your guy is much younger.
That don't have nothing to do with it. It's all about skills in hand, and he's ready for this.
All right,
he's ready for this.
We thank you for your comments. We'll let you get back to work there and working with your fighter. The comments of Ken Relaford, who's not only the trainer of Kendrick Relaford, but he's his dad. Trying to concentrate there. It's
Williamson trying to jab and move and employ some more angles in this round. Getting away with a sneaky right hand lead, which you don't do as a righty, but he was able to throw it and then move out of danger.
You know, you talked about him breaking that jaw and how he fought through the pain. This guy can hang in there pretty good, but at age 35, again, he's gonna win this fight, win it dramatic style, because these heavyweights right now, anybody that gets ranked, you don't get a shot at these titles. It's just kind of wide open.
It really is. You have to make your statement and win with emphasis. Relaford plays a good shot on.
Looping right hand again just before the bell.
Get over that, man.
How did you score that round, Gabe? It's hard for me to concentrate on the scoring when we're talking to Relaford Sr.
I thought Relaford had a slight edge. Very slight.
Number three, Bob Sheridan, Dave Bontempo, our principals in there in the heavyweight division. Devaro Williamson checked out the black with the red trim, and in the black and white is Kendrick Relaford. Relaford slightly out in front of the fight after two.
And he's been able to get the right hand home over the left hand of Williamson, who's trying to get on the outside, get the jab moving, and then trying to out-slick and out-experience his opponent. He's got the big amateur background.
Williamson has a 2-inch, 3-inch advantage in reach. A couple of inches anyway, we'll say. And he's trying to use that, and as I say that, it's Relaford gets his jab through there.
Now, even though the corner of Relaford says that the age has nothing to do with it, I disagree.
If
Williamson is fading because he's 35 years old, the younger fighter making him use his legs will make him pay the price for that.
I mean, this is a terrific opponent for Relaford, who, with a record of 8-3 and just 21 years of age, fighting a guy with a record of 18-2, it's perfect that he's 35 years old for him. So, in spite of what his dad says, you can take that with a grain of salt. He is his dad.
And he's caught up in the moment a little bit, too. And a good jab answered by Relaford as Williamson threw his out first. And Relaford getting comfortable in there on the countering end.
Charles digs down to the body that time. Doubles with the jab, pulling up with the right hand. You didn't see them really be getting into the right hand and throwing it with the power. We're going to talk to his corner and George Durbin momentarily and find out what he has to say about the way DeVarrell is getting off with the right hand. George, how about that right hand? You didn't see him landing with.
Yeah, it's about, you know, it's about, you know, getting the timing down again, you know, and through the last fight, you know, he probably a little, you know, got a little bit of shakes in him right now, but, you know, we're working it out. He's got to bend his knees better. He's got to snap that jab better, you know, and he's got to look like a young man in there, you know, like he wants to do something. But, you know, we'll bring it around. He's going to put it together as his timing goes.
Well, Dave mentioned earlier in the call that it's very difficult for a guy coming off a difficult loss to put things back together, but he looks like he's hanging right in there anyway.
Yeah, well, yeah, and that's true, you know, and that tells you where you're at, you know, how you come back and that sort of thing. So we're wanting him to get back and do the right thing, but, you know, he can't stand straight up and go straight back. Drag that jab back. We got to work on that and get it better going through the fight.
All right, thanks, George. We'll let you get back to working with DeVarrell. We appreciate the fellas coming in from the corner to share with us what they're thinking as we come to the closing seconds of the third round. If George Durbin trains DeVarrell Williamson.
Well, he went low, but he got something started. We'll see if it carries.
I don't know if Williamson did enough to win that round, Dave. I don't know.
A little weary of these shots that are hitting him.
And he's landing some shots, but there's not much power behind him. But you heard what George had to say. You know, he's just got to get it in his head. Get his head.
I don't know if you can get your timing during the fight, though. Has to be in the gym.
The answer to that question, Dave, you do know. You know you can't get your timing. Now you have to have the timing set when you go into the ring. You don't develop timing all of a sudden in the ring.
Now here's Williamson taking shots from Relaford, uppercut, being muscled here by Relaford. And then Williamson trying to get a combination of his own going. And he got the one shot in and just came up low, unintentional, as he was trying to get something started. We'll see if he found something at the end of the round.
All right, unofficially, I've given Relaford the low close rounds. I've given him the first three rounds of the fight. And that, if my indication, my scoring is any indication of the way the judges who are doing this one, by the way, are Peter Camatera, Michael Koenig, and Richie Drain. If they see it anyways, either way we see it, then Williamson has got to do more than what he's been doing for the first three rounds of this fight. We're in round number four in the 7-8 battle.
And how big is a 3-0 hole in terms of a 10-round fight? You would have to win 6 of the next 7 to get a points victory. So Williamson can't afford to dig any more of a hole. It's got to happen for him now.
And again, there's a possibility that, you know, he may have won one of those two, 3 rounds, but, you know, that's just the way we're seeing it. But nonetheless, there's not a lot separating them in any of these rounds. I think Relaford is landing heavier blows when he doesn't land. And right now, Williams doing that pretty nice job boxing. A little bit of motion up with his toes, sliding left. Lets his hands go. Relaford waiting right now. Williamson lets his hands go again. He holds up the right hand, but it's not there. And that's what you're talking about, the timing. You see, paw, 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 then he slipped a little bit. His right foot slipped out from underneath him on the logo there. And he got no power behind the right hand.
No, and he just threw the right hand there as if he would be a southpaw. It was a lead right hand for the right-handed fighter. He's pawing. He's basically taking shots and trying to rely on his experience. But he's going to go with whatever he's got right now.
Well, he's having his best round of the fight in this fourth round. With a minute to go, he's winning this round.
And he started at the end of the last round, including the low blow for Williamson.
What's Relaford doing now? He's not doing anything. He's just catching right now. He's taking this round off. misses his shot. Look, almost muscle out of that.
And he's waiting for Williamson to come in on him. And that's what happens when you get nailed a few times. You get a little tentative, and Williamson is opening up and really trying to make this more than just a dominance factor. He wants to do some damage here.
Well, he's certainly winning the fourth round more definitively than Relevant won any one of the first three rounds. Misses a shot, now he plants, but the uppercut has been there for Williamson. Rolls up the right hand, a glancing blow, but nonetheless it lands, the uppercut. It's a real nice round for Williamson.
And he wobbled Relaford with that last right hand.
And he's back at his heels now.
Relaford's in some trouble.
Yeah, he is. Closing seconds of the round, and he's gonna start throwing some shots back. Legs are all right, but he's taking a lot of punishment in this fourth round. That's the best round of the fight for Devon Williamson.
If he had a little bit more power, he might have stolen the 10-8 from somebody.
Deep breath. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you. Very good job. You can look at everything. Listen, you look at everything. Move. Convert. Put on two.
They talked him like he won that round. What's this thing?
Well, this is Williamson having his best round of the fight. Excellent uppercut there on Relaford. And then he would continue from this point as he's getting into his attack. Good uppercut again.
Moving the left hook.
He's loading everything in here. And he slapped with the right hand, but Williamson putting together a nice package of aggression here, and that carried him in round four.
All right, here we go with round number five. Let's see how this thing unfolds now. Can Williamson keep it up, or will Relaford stop and plan and start to fight again? Looks like he wants to be a little bit more aggressive, but Williamson tries to take it away from him in the early going here.
I think Williamson has hit another gear.
Yeah, he has, Dave. And even though Relevant was throwing shots there, Williamson caught them both in the gloves, set himself up. That one got through.
And you see a little bit more head movement here from Relevant, which was not there in the last round.
And he's a little bit using his legs a little bit more, bouncing a bit. Trying to be a better boxer here to try and take it away from Williamson, who outboxed him in the last round. The looping right hand, a little bit short. Cut a piece of him.
When Relaford can keep the jab out, they'll stop the big shots from coming in. But Williams is trying to ride his best momentum wave and get a couple rounds going.
It's pretty good pace, Dave. We've got to point out the fact these guys are big heavyweights. Williamson came in at 225 and Relaford is 238. These are big men.
They fight like the cruiserweights in terms of their pace. Good speed, good foot speed.
He's landing the shots though.
Williamson moving smartly now to his left, using the foot speed, jabbing, and trying to present more angles.
That chopping shot misses. It's a piece of him. He threw that uppercut with the determination that he did in the last round. But he's got rid of it backing off now. Back up with that right hand behind the ear. He may have hurt him a bit with one of those shots in there. There's a nice uppercut again. Oh, that uppercut has worked excellent for Williamson.
He really turns into it nicely. And Relaford toying with the southpaw style now, and it's a concession. The fact that Williamson is dominating him, and Williamson winning this round big as well.
Well, you talked about after the third round that Williamson had better do something because next to impossible, unless you start winning some rounds immediately to win this fight, any type of decision that it might go to. And all of a sudden, Williamson came on in the fourth and is having a good fifth round as well. Again, this is scheduled for 10 rounds. Neither fighter has been down. Relaford a little bit shaken in the last round. Nice uppercut. And he looked like he was almost ready to go that time. Okay, cut good with the uppercut. The uppercut has been the best weapon so far for Williamson.
That was the touch of sleep.
Got him again. Snapped the head twice. and the bell ends around, and that puts an exclamation point on it for Williamson to definitively win that round. So after Trey was looking like relevant was going to be able to outbox his way, Hanley, and all of a sudden Williamson is back and back nicely.
And he's been searching in rounds 4 and 5. Williamson making a nice home with the uppercut. Scores with it there nicely. And watch the leverage as he gets everything into these shots. Devar Williamson, knowing that an opportunity is standing right in front of him here. He's found the mark. Big uppercut from outside. Turns, he thought Relaford would fall, but it didn't happen.
All right, we're ready to go to round number 6 here at the Seminole Casino at Coconut Creek, Florida. I'm Bob Sheridan with Dave Bontempo, and Mark Goldberg is with us. And tomorrow, and our entire staff here, we're glad that you can be with us. We're going to be watching the principals in there. Earl Williamson with the black and red trunks, been coming on the past couple of rounds. And Kendrick Relaford, the 21-year-older with a record of 8-3. One draw, 5 knockouts in his record, has got a few problems now with a seasoned, gritty old 35-year-old named DeVarrell Williamson.
Williamson found another gear at the end of round 3, 4, and 5, very good to him, and this is a pivotal round. Relaford can't stack him, and Williamson may be able to just use his experience and the fact that he's used to winning more often.
Yeah, his experience and his uppercuts. And don't forget, he coming off that September loss to Messi, and a big disappointment for him because at 35 he really hasn't had a lot of time to wait. But the next several months in the heavyweight division, you know, almost by losing, by winning sometimes.
Yeah, he got an invitation off that first round knockout loss, but the invitation was not for big money.
And here he is, he's really working hard in this fight. Uppercut successful again. Relaford backing off. He's getting nailed by shots, not throwing any punches. I'll tell you one thing. You know, you said they're working like lightweight fighters. Again, I point out Williamson's 225. Relaford's 238. He's a big man, and the pace for heavyweights has been pretty darn good.
You would never know those weights by the way these guys are fighting. And Williamson is a different fighter, totally. He's moving more. He's firing combinations and not even jamming his way in, just firing, thinking that he could get to Relaford, maybe hoping to make it quick.
I'll tell you this, for a 35-year-old guy, he got himself in terrific shape because he hasn't stopped throwing punches. And now he's a borderline punishing Relaford right now. Because Relaford finally has that hang on, and referee Bill Connors has to separate the two guys one of the few times during the course of the fight. The time remaining in the 6th round. And Relaford, it's like 2 separate fights. Relaford the first 3 rounds, and Williamson the second 3 rounds.
And Williamson looking definitively stronger, holding command the last 3 rounds. And Relaford hasn't won a fight in his last 3. You get used to losing. I mean, he really needs to change the momentum, or he's on his way to another loss.
Blood trickling from his mouth hanging wide open. He's fatigued, very much so. 21-year-older at the bell is in nowhere near the condition that apparently the 35-year-old is.
2 rounds out of the last 3, a borderline 10-8.
Well, after 6, I get a dead even. By the way, Williamson and Relaford going down in those first 3 rounds. Relaford didn't win those rounds as definitively as any one of the 4th, 5th, or 6th rounds that Williamson won. I mean, there's no question. Hey,
you hear me? Come on, man. You gotta pick it up. You want these fucking guys to talk about? You want to do it?
It's a shot. You washed up, man. I want to see the box. You hear me? You guys stop it. Do something. Your hands are down to your side. Pick it up, you. Let's go right now. I just want you to go on your pay. You hear me? Let's go, man.
Williamson's up. uppercuts have been excellent form, and there's another example of it. Smart fighter, keeps going with what works. Sometimes we see guys have some success with a punch and not go back to it enough, but Williamson has made a home with that uppercut.
This is round number 7 again. It's scheduled for 10. Relevant has got to stop the bleeding, and I don't mean that literally. I mean he's got to stop the bleeding of losing rounds now. He's got to do what you said after the third round that Williamson was able to execute. He's got to turn this thing around now.
Now the question is, can he win close fights? He's lost decisions. He had a draw. And yeah, you blame the losses on bad decisions. Well, now here you are. You had a lead in this fight. What are you going to do with it now that the other guy is coming back?
And he still looks fatigued to me, Dave, in that his jaw is hanging down. He's not really super aggressive right now, and certainly his corner has had to tell him, hey, you got to get moving here, kid.
Well, in the first three rounds, Williamson looked like he was starting to get old. And then he found something at the end of the round, and basically was able to turn back the clock in that sense, and has had a lot of fire and intensity in his attack.
Cruising a little bit more in this round. He's not quite as aggressive as he had been. As I say that, he opens up a little bit. But you know, he's fighting with a lot more confidence. Look at his eyes, his left arm. Big slip there on that logo in the center.
Also, based on the pace that Relaford has given here, Williamson may try to win a cheap round now and then. One in which not a lot happens, where you almost take the round off, but you still win it because the other guy is not doing much.
All right, now Bill Connors says to Williamson, one more low blow and I'm going to take a point away. So he's going to watch out for that, because the fight is close enough that losing a point means he's going to win a whole other round again. Notice Williamson waiting more now, Dave. Sort of like he was in the first three rounds of the fight. But Relevant's not on top of it. He's not taking advantage of it.
This is the slowest round since early on. And this is an opportunity for Relevant to spring out and win. But what might be happening is Williamson could get that cheap round I was talking about. If you can win a round where not much happens, that's just as important as the other ones.
Still, I don't know if Relevant's done enough to get even a cheap round, as you call it.
I'm talking about Williamson.
Oh, yeah.
That's a cheap round. Not much happening compared to other rounds, but he still probably will walk off with this round.
I see. Okay. And he probably will. Williamson, so the referee's going to try to get that corner cleaned up over there, because there's a lot of water, and you notice in the last couple of rounds that the fighters have been slipping more on the logo. I think part of the reason is the relevant head seems to have relatively clean them. And then as the night progresses, as the water gets sloppy in the corner, these guys slip and slide around.
And a lot of injuries can happen. You slip and slide. It could be an ankle. It could be a ligament. So it's good to clean that up. Well, you figure that Relaford will probably have one more run in him. He's had four rounds that haven't gone his way after a good start. Let's see how his second win kicks in and what Williamson does.
He appears like he's got sort of a second win right now. We're in round number 8. This is a scheduled 10-round heavyweight fight. And it looks like Relaford wants to open up a bit now. And in spite of what his dad said when we talked to him in the box earlier in the fight, that you know, the age difference doesn't make any difference, but it does. We know that.
It certainly does. I mean, if you're a Rutherford, you're happy that Williamson is 35 now in a close fight instead of 25.
Absolutely. And it is a close fight, by the way. Only a point separating the two. But Rutherford has got to, as I mentioned, I don't want to use a trick stop and do it because it gives you the wrong idea. He's got to just stop these rounds from slipping away. He's giving away too many rounds, and he hasn't really given them away. Williamson's just outboxing him, really sort of out-hustling him a bit. So he's got to stay what he's doing right now. This is an even round. Rutherford's not doing anything to for the first minute and a half gone in this eighth round. He really steal this round and he's got his eyes.
No, it's been a slower round. Rounds 4 through 6 had a fiery pace to them for Williamson. And round 7, much cheaper round that he was able to get. At least fight 2 and they slow down. That's what the veteran guy wants. And if you're the younger fighter, that's when you have to make the veteran guy tired. But it hasn't worked out that way for Rutherford.
Rutherford had a relatively short amateur career, 18-3 as an amateur. And again, he started his professional career at 5-0. And then his recent fights have been 0-2-1. So, I mean, his career is on the line at age 21, but by golly, he's got to finish these fights strong.
Hey, a year without a win is a long time. Really? He's had that with the 3 fights. And yeah, now, this is the opportunity to put all those frustrations away. He started out quick. Williamson got back in the fight, but Rutherford is still here. And no excuses after this one if he doesn't do it all.
Well, you know, this is a round that he just might get.
Yep.
Because he just outworked this guy a little bit more in this round. And for Williamson, he kind of let it get away from him. Unless he wants to try an exclamation point in the air with him a few seconds to go in this eighth round. All right, there's the eighth round. So finally, we get a situation where Rutherford wins the round, and I got a dead even after 8 now.
I do too with the rider that the first 2 rounds, the first 3 rounds are pretty close. Rutherford got that all on our cards, but you know what? Even a judge has any of those rounds even, then Williamson gets the bounce, so that's how close it is.
Both guys need to win at least one of these rounds very definitively, because we had 3 rounds in the early going that were. As Daniel Santos, by the way, who's just signed.
Set your pace, dude.
WBO middleweight champion just signed with Warriors Boxing. We're sure to see him in action in the upcoming months here on Warriors Boxing. Boy, what a job they're all doing. Jesse Robinson is the head of boxing operations. Mitchell Cypress, the chairman of the Seminole Tribe, has given him full confidence, and he's done a nice job.
It's really nice to be on the ground floor of something ascending like this. You see the fighters coming in, the venues increasing, and there's a lot of momentum all the way around with the entire operation.
I know Chris Lawrence doesn't like us to mention him too often, but he's done a nice job in supporting Jesse, so we got to say that without that support, it's very hard for him to operate, and they're doing a great job keeping Warriors. You and I have been around a long time. We've seen a lot of boxing operations come and go. And this Warriors boxing is here to stay with the support of the Seminole Tribe and certainly the Hard Rock Cafe. The whole thing is just falling into place looking.
They're one of the major waves of the gaming and boxing coming together. They happen about once a decade, and this is the one right here.
And this is the 9th round in the scheduled 10-round heavyweight fight that had a good pace to it in the early going. It slowed down considerably in the 7th and 8th round here in the 9th. Both guys need these last 2 rounds to put a cap on a victory for either one of them.
And both guys should be happy they're in a position to get this, because for Williamson, he rallied back into it and put himself in a position to win. And for Rutherford, despite what happened in the middle rounds, because of his early lead, he's sitting here with a chance to do something with 2 rounds to go.
Here it is, the 35-year-old that is trying to outwork Rutherford right now. Williamson with the red trim and his black trunks is a little bit busy. That uppercut's been very successful. It's been absent the last couple of rounds. And in the middle rounds from the 4th, 5th, and 6th, that uppercut was very, very important and very successful for Williamson.
Well, when you're 35, it's hard to run the table from round 4 on all the way to round 10. He came up with a nice mini run that got himself going. and he shows you some of the vestiges of that here in round nine as Williamson trying to outcome and win this fight against Relaford with his experience, and it's been Relaford leaning on Williamson.
Again, Dave mentioned how Williamson stayed with the amateurs probably a little bit longer than he should have if he wanted to be serious as a professional. But he's got a pretty good record now of 8-10-6 on the winning. Oh, he caught him with a good shot that time. And he had hurt Relaford, and he's trying to finish him off. And down goes Relaford. That's up to 3 and 4. He'll be able to get back up as Bill Connors keeps the count going after 7 as he takes the standing 8 count. Remember, there is a 3 knockdown rule, and it's all over. The corner came up on the apron and indicated to the referee to stop the fight.
Well, you know, it was already going to be a 2-point round late here with the fighter falling and the blood coming out. You look at the total absence of conditioning left by Relaford, and Williamson, with his experience, had every chance to finish him off. I think it's a good move by the corner at that point, knowing that their fighter was going downhill from that spot.
Well, Dave, he was going to get back up as we take a couple of looks at it. Blood coming out profusely. Go ahead.
Here's Williamson with the huge right hand here, punctuating what he's done in the last minute of this round. And then when Relaford is able to get up from this, as Williamson comes on, Relaford is backing up here. He is letting Williamson take the fight to him. That is an indication of fatigue problems. Now he's down. So when he gets up and he's tired, are you going to let him take more abuse? The corner says no, especially with Williamson and his experience knowing how to finish a fight off. And for Devorah Williamson, this is a nice surge from round 4 on, and he showed a lot in coming back to win this fight.
Well, the big question is, at 35, how much more can he do? But all he can do is take it fight by fight, almost round by round at this stage of his career, and see where he can go. Remember, the world heavyweight champion is older than he is, if you're talking about Lennox Lewis. This guy, Williamson, did what he had to do tonight. He beat a younger guy who looked strong in the early going, and he hung right in there. Let's make it official by going to our ring announcer, Damian Pinto.
Ladies and gentlemen, this one comes to a stop at the 2:35 mark of round number 9. Referee Bill Connors, on advice from the corner, has put a stop to the action, making your winner by technical knockout, Devorah Williamson.
So the 35-year-old heavyweight that waited a long time before he came out of the amateur ranks, 103 knockouts, you know, he had as an amateur. That's pretty darn good, David. Was very impressive tonight for his age and the experience that he has against this young 21-year-old relevant.
He really was, and Devorah Williamson waiting so that he can obtain his college degree before becoming a boxer. He's got something to fall back on in his career, and here he fell back on his experience and took a different track from round 4 on.
All right, we're going to go up to the ring and have an interview with Devorah Williamson. So, Mark, if you've got him there, go ahead.
All right, thank you.